Hi, I'm Dr. Kathy Pereira, and I'm the director of the Duke School of Nursing Doctor of Nursing Practice Program. And I'm very excited to have this opportunity to talk to you about the Duke DNP. We were the first DNP program in the state of North Carolina, and we actually just celebrated our 10th anniversary in the fall of 2018. We have a very strong publication of manuscript rate from our students, and we just benchmarked our 200th publication also in fall of 2019. And so we're very proud of those scholarly accomplishments of our students and the faculty that mentor them. Our program is a distance-based curriculum, and that means that you do most of your learning online, and then you come to campus once a semester for interactive and face-to-face activities with both faculty and your colleagues in the program. This is very important and helps build a connection to Duke, helps you feel better supported to talk through problems with faculty and other colleagues, and really helps you get to know the cohort that you're in, which is extremely important when you're going through a rigorous doctoral program like the Duke DNP. First of all, we take students from all areas of advanced practice nursing, and that includes nurse anesthesia, nurse midwives, all the advanced practice nurse practitioner roles such as family, pediatric, acute, and primary care, women's health. We also take psych mental health nurse practitioners and CNS prepared advanced practice nurses. We also take nurses who have a master's degree in either nursing administration or informatics. So our CRNA program is what we call a BSN to DNP program, and these students start after completing a bachelor's degree and then getting some work experience. This program is 3 years in length total, and the students are full-time. We also have a post-MSN DNP, and these students take 5 semesters to complete their program. Additionally, in the spring of 2017, we started getting up our executive leadership specialty within the Duke DNP program. And this is designed especially for nurses who have a strong background already in nursing administration, leadership, both managing people and budgets. And it's a 9-credit elective specialty within the Duke DNP program. And we're really excited about this because it's really preparing nurses to be able to sit at the table in the C-suite and to be able to think at a very high strategic level within healthcare organizations. We are really proud of our graduates as they proceed with their careers after completing the Duke DNP. Our graduates are doing amazing things, and they're usually stepping up in their organizations, either taking on more responsibilities or taking on higher level leadership roles within their organizations. And so we've had students go on to testify before the Institute of Medicine. They're leading large healthcare organizations. They're working in government agencies. They're also working in the global arena. And we actually have the opportunity for our students to participate in international DNP projects while they're here. The Duke DNP really transforms you personally and professionally as you move through the program. Not only do you complete a project, but it really enhances your personal and professional leadership skills, enhances your ability to look at evidence with a really critical eye, and enhances your ability to understand healthcare policy and finance and how that influences healthcare systems and quality within healthcare. So we have a very diverse cohort of students. We have students who have maybe had their master's degree for 15 or 20 years as an advanced practice nurse and then want to go back for their DNP. We also have students within our MSN program who do what we call the BSN to DNP, complete their advanced practice courses and certification, and then go on to complete their DNP. We of course have our ABSN, our BSN to DNP nurse anesthesia students. We have students from all over the country. We actually have international students that come every year, and it's really a gamut of clinical expertise, from military expertise to women's health to nursing administration. So we're really excited about the fact that our cohorts are so diverse in their background, and that leads for really great interaction and enrichment in the classroom. So students also, when they apply for the program, should have at least an idea of the area where they would like to work on a project and that means they would like to work with what population of patients. So for instance, if you work in the cardiology setting, you might be interested in working with patients with heart failure. If you work in the nursing leadership setting, you might be interested in a project on retention of workforce. And so at least having a vague or general idea about what problem you would like to focus on during your DNP project. So I'm glad we had this opportunity to talk. I want to mention that I am a double Dukie. I actually graduated from the Duke MSN program in 2002 as a family nurse practitioner, and then also received my DNP from the Duke School of Nursing in 2012. And so I've been through this program. I'm really excited about what I learned and what we're teaching our students now. And I welcome the opportunity for you to contact me for any questions. And if you're interested in more, please explore our website and consider admission and application. Thanks.